Morning, students. I am sure you have revised previous two lectures of your physics chapter, Light. Let's discuss the rest part of it. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about human eye structure as well as working of it. Now, we will discuss how we can take care of our eyes. Eyes are not only very important sense organ but also very sensitive. So it is very necessary to take proper care of your eyes. Some points for care of your eyes are as follows. Number one, too bright or too dim light is bad for eyes. Insufficient light causes eyes strain and headache. Do not look at the sun or a powerful light directly, like laser light. Never rub your eyes. If particles of dust go into your eyes, wash your eyes with clean water. If there is no improvement, then go to a doctor. Fourth point is especially for the students as you are. Always read the book and newspaper at the normal distance for vision. Do not read by bringing your book too close to your eyes or keeping it too far. If there is any problem, you should go to an eye specialist. Let's continue with the some defects of eye. What are defects of eye? Defects of vision is actually the loss of power of accommodation of the eye. There are three mainly defects. Number one, myopia, which is also called as short-sightedness. Number two, hypermetropia, which is also called as farsightedness. Number three, cataract. Let's discuss in detail. Number one, myopia. What is myopia? A person with myopia can see near objects clearly while distant objects appear blurred. This disease is also called as short-sightedness or nearsightedness. This problem occurs when light rays entering the eye focus in front of retina rather than directly on it. And how it can be cured? Using the spectacles with concave lens can improve the vision in a myopic person. Next is hypermetropia. A person with hypermetropia can see distant objects clearly but cannot see nearby objects, and it is called as long-sightedness. This problem occurs when light rays entering the eye focus behind the retina rather than directly on it. It can be also cured. Spectacles with convex lenses can improve the vision in a hypermetropia person. Number three, cataract. During old age, eyesight becomes foggy. The eye lens becomes milky and cloudy, and thus the person cannot see clearly. Loss of vision. Maybe you have observed your grandparents are also complaining the same, ki they are not able to see clearly. So what is that? That is cataract. That may be cataract. Cataract is treated by surgery. In cataract surgery, the cloudy lens is removed and an artificial lens is transplanted in the eye. Our next topic is visually challenged person. Some people, including children, face with disability of vision. This disability of vision can be partial or complete. Such persons are called visually challenged persons. It means their ability to see has decreased. A visually challenged person usually show a marked development of other senses like sense of hearing or sense of touch. However, additional sources can enable them to develop their capabilities further, or we can say that some additional resources help them to increase their vision to a degree. And these resources are optical aids, non-optical aids. First, we will discuss optical aids. Optical aids help a person who is partially visually challenged. These aids enlarge an image or a text so that they could be visible. Optical aids includes bifocal lenses, contact lenses, tinted lenses, magnifiers, and telescopic aids. The lens combinations are also used to rectify visual limitations. Telescopic aids are available to view chalkboard and class demonstration. Non-optical aids. Non-optical aids help a person who is completely visually challenged. Non-optical aids include visual aids, tactual aids, auditory aids, and electronic aids. Visual aids can magnify words, provide suitable intensity of light and material at proper distances. Tactual aids using sense of touch to learn. It includes Braille writer slate and stylus help the visually challenged persons in taking notes, reading and writing. Auditory aids using sense of hearing to learn. It includes cassettes, tape recorders, talking books and other such devices. Electronic aids such as talking calculators are also available to perform many computational tasks. Closed circuits television, also an electronic aid which enlarges printed material with suitable contrast and illumination. Nowadays, use of audio cassettes and voice boxes with computers are also very, very helpful for listening to and writing the desired text. Braille system. It is the most popular resource for visually challenged persons. The present system was adopted in 1932. There was a person named Louis Braille. He was born in 1809 in France. He became blind due to an accident in his childhood at the age of 3. He developed the Braille script and published it in 1821. It is not a language. It is actually a system of some codes used for reading and writing. It can be used for common languages, mathematics and scientific notations. Many Indian languages like Hindi, Gujarati, Marathi, Bengali can be read and write using the Braille system. Now the question arises, what is this Braille script? It is actually a system which has 63 raised dot patterns or characters. Each character or pattern represents a letter, a combination of letters, a common word, or a grammatical sign. Dots are arranged in the cells of two vertical rows of three dots each. Here is example of dot patterns used in Braille system. C, A, T to form the word cat. Then and. Next is grammatical sign comma are written in this form. These patterns when embossed on Braille sheets help visually challenged persons to recognize words by touching. A reader needs to memorize each character. Braille texts can be produced by hands or by using machines. So, our chapter is over. Let's take a quick recap. Light is reflected from all the surfaces. Regular reflection takes place when white light falls on a smooth, polished, and regular surfaces. diffused reflection takes place from rough surfaces. There are two laws of reflection. Number one, the angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. Number two, incident ray, reflected ray and normal lie in the same plane. Image formed in the plane mirror undergoes lateral inversion. Two mirrors inclined to each other give multiple images. Sunlight is called white, but actually it is consists of seven colors. Splitting of white light into seven colors is called dispersion of light. Important parts of eye are cornea, iris, pupil, lens, retina, optic nerve. A normal eye can see nearby and distant objects clearly. Visually challenged person can read and write using the Braille system. Visually challenged persons develop their other senses more sharply to improve their interaction with environment. So, thank you children. I hope all the concepts are clear and you have enjoyed the interesting chapter, Light.